Good evening, students. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Good. So what were the problems? What was the last topic we were doing? I guess we started second this thing, right? Second order differentiation. That is double differentiation.
Sir.
Yeah, Surya.
Sir. Sir, have you uploaded the solution for the assignment that he gave yesterday? Because I couldn't do the sums properly. I haven't submitted that yet, sir.
Okay. Whichever you completed, you submit. See, next time onward, don't hold it. Even if you do only 50% of it and the remaining 50% is a doubt, you upload it, okay?
Okay.
Because everything is being tracked up. We'll track on how much you're working, when you're submitting everything. Because then we'll have an understanding of what you're doing. So upload it. If there is any doubt, next day or in the student support number, you ensure the doubts are clear.
Okay, sir.
So you're always free to approach.
I thought I'll submit after class.
Don't do that mistake. This is for everyone. Not only for you, this is for everyone. If you guys have this kind of a thought in your mind so that you feel that you didn't do which is required for the assignment to be completed, nothing of that sort. You know, only 40% of the paper, do it sincerely. That is, I'm expecting only sincerity. Just for sake of completing, don't copy it from the net and just submit something to you who is going to struggle. Okay. Anyway, since you asked me, I'll start with doubts itself. What were the tough parts? Tell me.
The 13th question, sir.
1 minute. Just give me a minute. Okay. I'll just pull the question paper. Just a second. Yeah. I got the question paper.
So for me,
13. Who was asking it? You know the name?
Sushindran was asking.
Sushindran, okay.
For me, from 10th itself, sir.
For you, from 10th, you
yes,
didn't
sir. Understand. Yes, sir.
Okay. So will you be able to solve if I give hint to Surya?
Somewhat, sir, but I don't think I can get the exact steps correctly.
Try it. Don't worry. Okay, try it, man. If you don't get it,
excuse me.
Sushindra, you asked 13th, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, 13th, actually. I'm sorry, the question came from applications of the area. You can leave it as of now. If you didn't do it, not an issue.
Sir?
Okay.
Yeah, please, sir.
I have 5 questions. I have a doubt, sir.
You have 5th
one, 10th one, 11th, 12th, and 13th, and 15th.
11th. Okay, 13th you can leave. 13th you can leave. Sushindran, any other doubt other than 13th? Though?
Sir, I didn't get the answer for last one, sir. Sir, 16th.
You didn't get the answer, na? How do you know 16th. That?
16th, sir, the proving, sir. Show that.
16th one you didn't get it, sir. Share it, I will do it now. Okay. Okay.
Others, you fourth call. One, I didn't get the answer, sir.
Edupa?
Fourth one.
Sir,
fourth one, I don't know how to do.
Fourth one, you didn't know how to. Sir, I'll teach you, not a big deal. Next. Yeah.
So, eighth one, sir. That proof question.
Okay, eighth also is a doubt. Next.
10, 11, and 12, sir.
10, 11, and 12,
Yes, sir.
Okay, so fourth. Ankit Ram, it is fourth problem for you. Anandita, you are saying something. What is it? Which problem? Huh? Okay.
Sir, for me, 11, 12. Rohan said that. So.
Rohan said that, right? Okay. So Shipra, it is 8 for you, right?
Yes, sir.
8th question.
Even 5th one, sir. 5th one also.
5th, okay. I'll teach. Not a big deal. Okay. That's it, right? And 16th, Swatiha asked. 16th, I think someone else also told me. Sushindran, right? Right, all others were easy? I hope you guys did. Okay, let's see. But I want you guys to tell me the idea, okay? So Ankit, let's start with you. Because fourth is a doubt for you, right? So y is equal to sine inverse x is there, right? We need to prove that the second derivative of this y is equal to sine inverse x is d square y by dx square is equal to x divided by 1 minus x square the whole power 3 by 2. Okay. It's actually a simple problem. Maybe you would have done some mistake in some step. But anyways, you will understand it. Just a minute. Ankit.
Yes, sir.
So, fourth is equal to, y is equal to sine inverse x. See, many times what happens with most of the people, they don't remember the formula for the inverse trigonometry. So, if that is the case, right, what you can always do is, you can try to write it in the form of trigonometric and then solve it, if you don't know. But for this problem, I would suggest you to directly go. So, what is the first derivative? Dy by dx is equal to, who can tell me the formula? Ankit, you yourself tell me. What is the formula for derivative of sine inverse x? Don't remember? 1 by root of 1 minus x square. So, d square y by dx square is how much? By the way, do you guys know what is the derivative of 1 by x? So, derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. I think we have discussed this, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So, here it is in the form 1 by f of x. Correct, Adam. So,
yes,
if y is equal to f of x, or it is like this. If it is of the form 1 by f of x, then dy by dx will be equal to minus 1 by f of x the whole square into f dash of x. Always change rule only. Seriya? So, using the same logic, tell me minus 1 divided by, what am I supposed to do? I need to take the square root. Yeah, square root of 1 minus x square, the whole square. So, square root and square will get eliminated. So, what is it we are left out with, guys? Root of
1 minus x square.
Root of 1 minus x square. Because root of 1 minus x square itself is f of x. So, what is the derivative of square root? That is 1 by 2
root x.
Correct? So, 1 by 2 into root of 1 minus x square into, now you do the derivative of 1 minus x square, which is going to give you minus 2x. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Minus of minus is a plus. X divided by 1 minus x square, the whole power 3 by 2. I think that is what they are asking us to do.
Yes, sir.
Got it? This is answer.
I have a doubt in this.
Yeah, please tell me that.
If you use the u by v rule, will it come, sir?
Yeah.
Division
quotient. It's right. Because see, we got the formula for 1 by x itself by using u by v. Because these are all generally famous functions, no? I skip certain steps.
Okay.
But if you're not comfortable, you can always use the u by quotient. That's right. But I hope this method is clear to everyone, right?
Yes, sir.
Fifth one, what are they asking? The f of x is equal to x square minus 16 by x minus 4. If the function is at the point x not equal to 4, is continuous at 4, find k. So, when a function is continuous at a particular point, what is the meaning? Limit x tends to c, f of x is equal to f of c.
Yes, sir.
So, at which point are you going to apply the limit? At which point are you going to find the function value? I mean, which function you will find using limits, which one you will find directly function value? This is the
x
function
equals
value. Yes. So, can I write limit x tends to 4, x square minus 16 divided by x minus 4 is equal to f of 4 is how much? Is it not k?
Yes.
So, this one, if you substitute 4, what will happen? 16 minus 16 by 4 minus 4. It be of the form 0 by 0. So, you should always simplify it. X minus 4 into x plus 4 divided by x minus 4. Cancel it. So, k is how much term?
8, sir.
That's it.
K is 4, right?
8. Okay. So, k is 8. So, shall I move on to the 8th one?
Yes,
let's
sir.
Let's see how to solve.
Yes, sir.
Rohan, you want to tell me the steps? Let me see what mistake you get. Is there anyone who got the answer for this? I'm asking you to verify whether the question is right or not.
I got a huge step and then I left it, so I couldn't find it.
Okay. So someone else should have got the answer. No, is there anyone with the answer?
Yes, sir. I got it.
You got it, huh? Okay. And question is right only. Oh, sorry. Rohan, can you please read the question? Y is equal to e power ax cos bx.
Cos bx.
Okay. What is that we are supposed to prove? I'm not able to hear you. So y double dash. Yeah, you can tell me in terms of y double dash. Y double dash minus 2a.
Y dash.
Y dash. 2a y dash plus a square plus b square into 1. Into y is equal to 0. Okay. So for these kind of problems, no, always take the question itself as equation number 1. Okay. Then what is y dash then? You're going to apply a product rule and chain rule in the process. So it is going to be e power ax into derivative of cos bx is minus sine bx into b plus cos bx into derivative of e power ax is e power ax into a. Correct? So what I will do here itself is this e power ax into cos bx is there, no? What can I replace it with?
Y.
Y. So y dash is equal to minus b into e power ax into sine bx. I am not disturbing it. Plus a times y. Can I write it like this? So let me call this as 2. Sharia. So differentiating to y double dash, what I will get? Minus b undisturbed e power ax into derivative of sine is cos bx,
cos bx.
Plus sine bx into e power ax into a dash plus a into y dash. Sharia.
Y, sir.
Won't it be a into b? Sin bx into e power ax into a into b.
No, but I put a bracket outside. No?
Okay, sir.
Shouldn't it be a into y, not y dash?
Engra, where?
Y double dash, sir. The last line.
A into y dash, sir. No? A is a constant. Derivative of y is y dash.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, I will call this as 3. So, what I am going to do is, this a y dash I am not going to disturb. Okay. Let me see what we can do. So, y double dash is equal to minus b into... See, what I am doing is actually a procedure followed in differential equation. I think I would have already told this to you guys. Okay. Because I am trying to manipulate things here. Suppose you don't get this idea. What you can do is, you can name them as 1, 2 and 3 and just take and substitute it in this expression. You will get the answer. You will still get it. But this here, I am trying to just manipulate things. See, for example, e power ax into cos bx. What is that?
Y, sir.
Y. So, by plus a into e power ax into sine bx plus ay dash. Okay. So, what do I need to do? If you look at the final expression that they have given, y double dash is there, y dash is there, y is there. But what is the unnecessary thing for us?
A square plus b square.
No. This thing. This e power ax into sine bx is not there. So, we need to eliminate. So, for that, let's think what can we do. So, from the second step, can I write e power ax into sine bx as, let me call this as 4. From 2, can I write e power ax into sin bx as, what will come? Y dash minus ay divided by minus bf.
Yes, sir.
Minus ay by minus b. Let me call this as 5. I will take 5 and substitute it in 4. Now I think we got the answer. Y double dash is equal to minus b square y minus a b into this whole thing, that is y dash minus ay divided by minus b plus ay dash.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this and this will get cancelled. So y double dash is equal to minus b square y minus ay dash, sorry, plus ay dash. So minus
a square y.
Minus a square y plus ay dash. Correct? So y double dash is equal to this ay dash and ay dash will give you 2ay dash. This whole thing will give you minus of a square plus b square into y. So y double dash minus 2ay dash plus a square plus b square into y is equal to 0. I hope this is what they're asking, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is how you solve them. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So please make a note of this. It's a good problem. Can I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
1 second, sir.
So what are the next one you guys told? 10th.
Yes, sir.
Sine square y plus cos x y is equal to k.
Sine square y plus cos x y is equal to 1, y is equal to pi by 4.
Then find dy by dx at 1 comma pi by 4. Okay.
Yes, sir.
When x is 1 and y is pi by 4. That's it. So let's proceed. No, it's an implicit function. Just directly proceed. So derivative of sine square y is 2 sine y into cos y. Plus derivative of cos xy is minus sine of xy into xy dash plus y. Do you guys understand what I do? So derivative of cos is minus sine. Minus sine into xy into derivative of xy is nothing but x into dy by dx plus y into derivative of x, which is 1. Okay. Is equal to derivative of k is 0 because it's a constant. Right?
Yes.
You need not do anything. Just take these values and substitute it here. 2 into, in the place of y, I will put pi by 4. In the place of y, again, I'll put pi by 4. Minus sine into, what is xy, guys? X into y is again pi by 4 into x is 1, y dash plus y is pi by 4 is equal to 0. Am I clear till this step?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So sine pi by 4 into cos pi by 4 is half. So 2 into half is 1 minus sine pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 into y dash plus pi by 4 is equal to 0. So 1 is equal to y dash plus pi by 4 by root 2. This goes to the other side. Y dash is equal to root 2 minus pi by 4. This is the answer. Clear?
Yes.
That's the answer. Okay. Moving on to the next problem. So 10th is over. 11th, I accept 11th is slightly a tougher problem because that expression is so big, right? But I'll tell you a different way of solving this. Please make this problem as mark as important is. So y is equal to sine inverse of x into root of 1 minus x minus root x into root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Then what are we supposed to do? X belongs to here, one important point is given, 0 to 1. Find dy by dx. Now you guys tell me, how did you proceed? Did you take y is equal to derivative of sine inverse as 1 by whole root of everything and then you proceeded?
Yes, sir.
No,
so that
sir.
Is where we get stuck. That is where we get stuck. See, I'm telling you the way I think, okay? If this problem was given to me in exam, to be very honest, I'll not say I'm not comfortable, but I, as far as possible, I'll try to eliminate inverse. Because of the way the formula is aligned, 1 by root of 1 minus x square, I don't like such expressions. Okay. So, having that in mind, if I need to get rid of this inverse, what am I supposed to do? What should I have?
Play with sine x.
I should have sine of something. I should have sine of something. I will try to write it in terms of sine of something. So, that I'll have only that something and I can proceed. Okay, so for that, how can we do it? That's what we need to think. So, listen. Sine inverse of x into root of 1 minus this x, guys, listen to this carefully. Can I write this x as root x the whole square?
Yes, sir.
Minus root x into root of 1 minus x square. Okay. So, if I need sine inverse of sine of something, if I am able to write this whole expression in the form of sine a cos b minus cos a sine b, then my issue is resolved. Correct? If I write it in the form of sine a cos b, if it means if I'm able to call this as sine alpha, if I'm able to call this as cos beta, then this should be cos alpha and this should be sine beta, if that is the way the expression is aligned. So that what will happen, guys? It will become sine of alpha minus beta. Guys, am I clear? Are you guys able to understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sine beta into cos alpha. So I'm looking at this expression. I will take this term. So I will take root x as sine beta and x as sine alpha. So how did I get that idea? Look at this. If I take x as sine alpha, then root of 1 minus x square will be cos alpha. If I take root x as sine beta, that implies root of 1 minus x is cos beta. So that I can substitute it here. If I do this, what will happen to this expression base? Sine inverse of, is it not sine of alpha minus beta? Guys, am I clear till this step? Are you guys able to understand the thought process? I'm more interested in that. Are you guys able to understand the thought process?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
now basically, I'm going to ask you another question. Be alert. So this is going to be alpha minus beta. So sine inverse of sine of alpha minus beta, this thing. So what is alpha, guys? Alpha is sine inverse of x minus beta is sine inverse of root x. So what we have done is the bigger expression has got simplified as sine inverse x minus sine inverse of root x. Now can you differentiate? So what is dy by dx? It is root of 1 by root of 1 minus x square minus 1 by 1 minus x into derivative of root x, that is 1 by 2 root x. So this is the final expression. Clear guys? Am I clear with this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm going to twist the question. Cos inverse of x into root of 1 minus x minus root x into root of 1 minus x. You guys think and tell me. You guys first think and tell me if it is going to work in the first place. So tell me the logic. What are we supposed to do? Cos inverse, we need to get rid of it. So I will write something in terms of cos. So to get something in terms of cos, recollect the formula. No? What is cos of a plus b? Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So what is cos of a minus b? Cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. So here, what feasibility do I have? I have the chance of writing it in terms of cos A cos B plus sin A sin. Cos of A plus B. So I will do only trial and error. If I put cos alpha, this as cos alpha, then root of 1 minus x square will be sin alpha. Then what should I take this as?
Cos beta
so
and sin beta. Correct?
So, cos inverse of cos of alpha minus beta. So, what will I get? Alpha minus beta. But what is alpha, guys?
Cos inverse x minus
cos inverse alpha
minus sin plus beta. Sorry.
Okay. Now you guys know how to differentiate this part. I'm leaving it here.
Could you go up a bit?
Yeah. Want me to go one more up?
I have a doubt here.
Please tell.
How did we get cos inverse after dy by dx? How did we convert it?
For which one?
After dy by dx, then we got y equal to cos inverse of. How did we get it, sir?
Well, in this problem, huh? Second one.
Yes, sir. This one, y equal to cos inverse. About that,
I put x is equal to cos alpha. No? Then what is alpha?
Not that, sir. Above one. Like above, it's given dy by dx equal to 1 by root 1 minus x. How did we get cos inverse in the next?
We are asking. I didn't get nothing. There is no cos inverse, but I'm not able to see a cos inverse. I'm not able to get your question. Where is cos inverse in this expression?
So after this. After this.
This one, huh? So you are saying this thing, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. How are they related? How did we relate?
I just put a question. That's it. See, this is my question. The previous question is over with this. Sorry if I have confused you. The previous question's answer is this thing only. Okay. So what was the previous question? Sine inverse of x into root of 1 minus x minus root x into root of 1 minus x square. No. I just tried to manipulate instead of sine inverse, what would have happened had there been cos inverse. Just to understand how you people are.
Now I get it, sir.
This is a different question. Okay. So that is for the 12th one. That is the reason why, if you see, x value is given as less than 1. Or else you cannot substitute, no? Because the range of sine inverse and cos inverse is between minus 1 to 1. Okay, that is the reason. So the 12th one is also a doubt, right? Y log x is equal to x minus 5. Y log x is equal to x minus y. What are we supposed to prove up? dy by dx is equal to log x divided by 1 plus log x the whole square. Okay. So how we proceed? Treat it as an implicit function and proceed. That is one way. Or just rearrange the equation. Y into 1 plus log x is equal to x. Correct? So you can either start solving it like this, or you can write y is equal to x divided by 1 plus log x. Now apply u by v rule. Y dash is equal to 1 plus log x into derivative of x is 1 minus x into 1 plus log x will be 1 by x, the whole divided by 1 plus log x, the whole square. So x and x will get cancelled, 1 and 1 are gone. What is the answer? Clear? That's it. So if you ask me how I got this idea of rearranging, whenever you have a square in the denominator, right, the square in the denominator is possible only when you apply u by v, right? So I try to ensure that the 1 plus log x is in the denominator. So I rearrange the equation and then solve. So you can ask me, sir, is this the only way to solve? No, I'm not saying. If you start using the product rule here and start solving, you will get it. But maybe the number of steps will be more than so. Okay, I hope this is clear.
Yes.
13th, I told you. Yeah, 16th, who had this doubt? Sushindra, right? Are you there? Sign off log y divided by a. Show that 1 minus x square into y2 minus xy1 minus a square y is equal to 0. Okay. How to solve? If somebody can tell me how did you guys proceed, I will understand. Maybe you can think if there is an alternate way to solve this also. Can we try? Okay. See, one thing I'm able to observe by looking at the right side expression. What is not there? I don't want that log to exist. Right? We don't want that log to exist. So what we can try is, we can try this. Can I write log y by a is equal to sine inverse of x? So log y is equal to a times sine inverse of x. You can ask me, sir, why did you want to write it in terms of sine inverse? Because I am able to observe this 1 minus x square. Okay. So now let's recollect the derivative of what is sine inverse. So it is 1 by root of 1 minus x square. But if I differentiate it twice, I have a possibility of eliminating the square root. So that is where I got the idea of rearranging. Okay. So 1 by y into y dash is equal to a into derivative of sine inverse x over 1 by root of 1 minus x square. That's simple as that. That's it. Now, can you guys apply u by v rule to this y into y double dash minus y dash into y dash okay, before that, what I will do is I will have y dash is equal to ay divided by root of 1 minus x square. This is 2. So let me call this itself as 1. So y dash into y dash, the whole divided by y square is equal to a into What is the derivative of 1 by root of 1 minus x squared? It is something similar to the fourth problem that we did. I think it is getting complicated. Okay, let's do one thing. This will become tough for you guys to handle because you will have 3 by 2 and all in the denominator. I don't want those issues to exist. Let's solve it directly and see what we are going to do. How to do this? So let's take this as 1. 1 is equal to cos of log y by a into 1 by a into 1 by y into y dash. Correct? So let this be equation number. So again differentiated, 0 is equal to derivative of cos minus sine of log y by a into 1 by a into 1 by y into y dash. So why did they write 1 by a? Sorry. Correct one. 1 by a y into y dash. Into 1 by ay into y dash. Any doubt in this step, guys? Any doubt in this step?
No doubt, sir.
Shall I proceed then? 0 is equal to cos of log y by a into this y dash by y, I will treat it as another function. So I'm going to apply product rule. 1 by a is going to be here. Okay, 1 by a into derivative of cos is minus sine of log y by a into 1 by ay into y dash multiplied with y dash divided by y. Plus, cos of log y by a into what is derivative of y dash by y dash? Correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, the sine of log y by a, what can I write it as? I can write it as x. So, this a will go to the other side. So, 0 is equal to minus y dash square divided by ay square into x plus so in the place of, from this I'm getting an idea. In the place of cos of log y by a, I can write it as ay divided by y dash. Let me call this as 2. So this whole thing, I will call it as ay divided by y dash into y into y double dash minus y dash square, the whole divided by y square. Clear this? Okay. So, x into y dash square divided by ay square is equal to ay divided by y dash into y double dash minus y dash square divided by y square. So, y and this y will get cancelled. This y and this will get cancelled. I'm getting y dash cube also. It's written again. Anybody else who got the answer for this problem? Nobody got it? Nobody got it, huh? So let's see. Let me proceed in the previous method itself. Log y is equal to a times sine inverse x. I feel this is better. So log y is equal to a times sine inverse x. Yes. So 1 by y into y dash is equal to a divided by root of 1 minus x square. So y dash is equal to ay divided by root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Now we will do y double dash. Tell me what is y double dash means. It is root of 1 minus x square into ay dash minus ay into derivative of root of 1 minus x square is 1 by 2 root of 1 minus x square into minus 2x. Any doubt in that step? Divided by 1 minus x square. I think we got the answer. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So I'll take this 1 minus x square to the other side. So 1 minus x square into y double dash is equal to a into root of 1 minus x square I'll take the LCM. So if I take the LCM, what will I get? A into 1 minus x square into y dash minus AXY the whole
divided. Everything by root of
n. So what are they asking? One minus x square into y two minus xy one. Let's see. A into AXY divided by root of 1 minus x square. So can I do this thing? Root of 1 minus x square, can I write it as AY divided by y dash?
Yes, sir.
Right, I'm just manipulating and seeing. Let's see. AY dash minus AX square y dash minus AXY divided by root of 1 minus x square is AY divided by y dash. So y dash will go to the numerator. So ay dash minus ax square y dash minus axy, the whole multiplied with y dash divided by a into y. This and this will get cancelled. A will get cancelled. So I have y dash square minus x square into y dash square minus xy into y dash, the whole divided by y. We are not getting, no? I think there is some mistake that I did. Can I check this problem alone and get back? I'll try to solve it and send it by today after the class is over. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I'll check this. I have some space constraint also. I'm not able to move up and down. Okay, I'll solve it in a notebook, take a screenshot and explain it and send it to you guys. Anything else, guys?
No, sir.
1 minute. I think we can proceed with our exercise, right? See, I think after doing all those bigger problems, now you should feel the exercise to be easy. So what was the last problem that we did, guys? 13th or 12th? I don't remember. 13th was last term. Okay. So 13th we finished. So can we try the 14th? Sorry. Can we try the 14th one? So y is equal to a into e power mx plus b into e power nx. So d square y by dx square minus of m plus n into y dash is plus mn into y is equal to 0. A e power mx. So y dash is equal to how much?
Sir, a e m power x into m plus
a b e m into e power m, or m power x, yes, plus b into e power m. Correct? Correct. So y double dash will be equal to a m square into e power mx plus b n square into e power mx. What you can do is take all these values and substitute it there, you will get the answer. Take all these values, substitute it in the left side equation, and the right side will automatically come out as 0. Okay. Similar is the 15th also. Right. So what about the 16th? E power y into x plus 1 is equal to 1. Show that d square y by dx square is equal to dy by dx the whole square. Simple. So e power y is equal to x plus 1. So what will you do? E power y into x plus 1 is equal to 1.
So take e power y the other side, sir, or x plus 1 the other
side. Or x plus 1 the other side will be better. It will be 1 by x plus 1. If you want, you can take a log also and then proceed. So if you take log, y will be equal to log of 1 by x plus 1. That is one way. Or I would suggest don't take log. It won't take at all. Because dealing with e power something is easier. So e power y into y dash is equal to minus 1 by x plus 1 the whole square. Right. So now I know that e power y is 1 by x plus 1. So in the place of e power y, I'll write 1 by x plus 1 into y dash is equal to minus 1 by x plus 1 the whole square. Cancel it. So what is y dash guys? Minus 1 by x plus 1. So what is y double dash? Minus 1 by x plus 1 the whole square. So take this and substitute it in the equation. No. Y double dash is. Plus 1 by x plus 1 the whole square. Did you guys understand why it is plus 1 by x plus 1 the whole square? Because derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Here it is minus 1 by x, so it will be plus 1 by x square. Okay. So y double dash, is it not exactly the square of this?
Yes, sir.
That's the answer. Okay. Next one also, I'm leaving it to you guys. I don't think the exercise problems are tough. Okay. So just wanted to say that we are at the verge of completing, that is, there is only one topic that is left out, that is mean value theorem and Rolle's theorem, which is a very, very, very simple concept. We'll be dealing it tomorrow, and in tomorrow's class, we'll be completing this chapter. And by end of day, you will be getting the list of questions for this month. Okay, so as I mentioned previously,
that, This week, do we have a test, sir?
Yeah, you do.
On inverse trigonometric functions.
Inverse trigonometry. As I mentioned the previous year, inverse trigonometry will have a test. So practice it. If there is any doubt, you have 4 days time. If there is any doubt, you can reach out.
Sir, the date of the first school examination has also been set, sir.
When is it?
The second week of July, like July 15th.
July 15th, we will be completing all
the first 4 chapters, sir.
Okay. No issue. You want to test in those chapters also, I give. Matrices, determinants.
Sir, what should I do if I have a doubt in matrices, sir?
You can reach out. Just send a screenshot and type and send whatever doubts you have.
Not for a sum, sir, for a topic.
Topic doubt, now you let me know the topic, I'll record a video.
Okay.
Mostly, I think everybody will have issue only with inverse, but the two, the row and the column operations.
The elementary transformation, sir.
Elementary, that's what I'm saying. Elementary transformation. Because you can find inverse using two methods. One is elementary transformation, and second is the method of adjoint. Correct? No? Adjoint is an easy one. I'll tell you that, though, nothing to worry. Inverse, what you need to do, just to give an outline for those who know matrices and determinants. First, whenever a problem is given asking you to follow elementary transformation, find the inverse using the adjoint, because you'll get it in 4 to 5 steps if you do a rough work also. Then try to bring it up using the row and the column transformation. So that you will have an assurance that your answer is right. Okay. Anyway, so can I write me just after me? Okay. Any other doubt, guys?
No doubt. No, sir.
Okay, then we can wind up. We'll see. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Mithra, I'll send it soon. I don't worry.